Hello all my dear student friends, welcome to this session. Now let us study the common rail direct injection system or the CRDI system. So this system is used for the advanced fuel injection in the IC engines. So in CRDI, the fuel injection or the supply of the fuel is controlled by ECU, electronic control unit. So in common rail direct injection system, the fuel injection is controlled by the electronic control unit. So the injectors are also advanced. These injectors are also controlled by the electronic control unit. Now for this purpose, in order to control the injectors, in order to control the timing of the opening of the injectors, in order to control the duration of the opening, in order to control the fuel supply rate, so many factors have to be controlled. And for this purpose, the electronic control unit will get the inputs from various sensors. So many sensors are used in the engines, and these sensors will give the feedback to the electronic control unit. The temperature sensors are there. The temperature sensors for sensing the temperature of the coolant, the engine temperature, then the intake pressure is also sensed. The intake pressure of the air which is entering in the engine, that is also sensed. At the same time, the pressure of the fuel which is supplied is also sensed. In this case, the pressure which is present inside this common rail or common header, this is a header pipe, and in this header pipe the pressure is something like 1600 bar. So this pressure is also maintained, and for that purpose it is sensed by the electronic control unit. Then the throttle position is also sensed by the electronic control unit. That means with the help of the throttle position sensor, the judgment regarding the load on the vehicle is also taken by the electronic control unit. So when the load on the vehicle increases, automatically the throttle position changes. So manually the throttle position is being changed by the pressing the accelerator pedal. So when the driver presses the accelerator pedal, then the throttle position is changed. The throttle valve is opened more, the opening is increased, so that the more charge can be delivered to the engine, so as to compensate for the increased demand in power. So that is also sensed by the electronic control unit. The RPM is sensed by the electronic control unit. The crank RPM of the crankshaft, the speed of the crankshaft is sensed by the electronic control unit. Then the crank position is also sensed by the electronic control unit. The ECU also senses the air mass intake. So how much air is entering inside the engine, that is also sensed. The vacuum is sensed. So many parameters are sensed by the electronic control unit, and then the calculations are done automatically by the electronic control unit, and thus it is decided that how much quantity of fuel should be injected by the injectors, what should be the rate of injection of fuel, what should be the timing of the fuel injection, exact timing in say microseconds or milliseconds, then what should be the duration of the injection of the fuel, that is also controlled by the electronic control unit, and this will definitely improve the combustion of the engine, and this will thus improve the performance of the engine. So the ECU will calculate the precise amount of fuel and the injection timing. The injection timing for the injection of the fuel, as well as the precise quantity of fuel, precise amount of fuel, and the rate of fuel supply, then the exact duration, all these things are calculated by the ECU, and accordingly they are controlled, accordingly only the fuel is injected inside the engine cylinder. So for this we are using the solenoid injectors, that is the electrically operated injectors are used. The electrical signal is obtained from the electronic control unit. Now in this CRDI system we are using a single pump, single high pressure pump. So this is the single high pressure pump which is used to increase the pressure of the fuel, and this is nothing but the common header or common rail, that is a pipe in which the fuel is present at a very high pressure, like 1600 bar. So the pressure is increased by a single pump. One additional pump can be used to lift the fuel from the fuel tank. So this is the fuel tank, and we can use a pump here. Here this pump is not shown, but we can use one more pump for just for lifting the fuel up to the fuel pump, the main fuel pump, which will increase the pressure of the fuel tremendously, that is up to the 1600 bar. We are also providing a filter in between so that the unwanted particles, the foreign particles from the fuel, can be removed by the filter before this fuel passes to the main fuel pump and to the header and ultimately to the fuel injectors. So let us study the working. First of all, the various sensors will give the input to the electronic control unit. So here you can see these are the injectors 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the electronically controlled injectors. They are not controlled mechanically, but they are controlled electronically by the electronic control unit. But here it is, you can see that the injection timing and the opening and the closing of the injectors, that is also sensed by the electronic control. It is sensed as well as controlled by the electronic control unit. So the opening and closing of these particular injectors is sensed as well as controlled by the electronic control unit. So the electronic control unit will also sense the pressure in this common rail pressure sensor. So this is the header pipe, that is the common rail pressure sensor. So in this particular pipe, what is the pressure? So whether it is reduced below 1600 bar or not, so that is also sensed by the electronic control unit. So there are several sensors. The temperature of the coolant is also sensed, that means the engine temperature is sensed by the electronic control unit. So many parameters are first of all sensed by the electronic control unit. All these blue lines shows the connections of the sensors with the electronic control unit. The signal is transferred from all the sensors to the electronic control unit, and then the electronic control unit will in turn control the injectors, the opening and closing of the injectors, the quantity of fuel, the fuel rate, the timing of the injection of the fuel, the fuel injection profile. All these parameters are controlled by the electronic control unit. So this is the fuel tank. Here we are using one pump for lifting the fuel, and then the fuel is entering inside the fuel filter. It is filtered in the fuel filter, and finally now the fuel is pumped. It enters this main pump, main fuel pump. So from this pump, this fuel is passing to the common rail, that is the common header. So this fuel pump will increase the pressure, and this increased pressure fuel will be supplied to this common header, and the pressure of the fuel in this common header will be around 1600 bar. Now from this common header, fuel is supplied at right time to each injector. So even if the fuel is being supplied to one injector, there will be no change, no remarkable change in the pressure in the header. So that simultaneously fuel can be injected in two injectors also if required. So these injectors are operated electronically by the electronic control unit. They are not operated mechanically. So only the pressure is always available, but until and unless the fuel injector is opened by the signal through the electronic control unit, the fuel will not be injected inside the engine cylinder, but this header is ready to supply the fuel to the injectors at high pressure. And thus, in this way, the fuel injection is controlled very precisely. So many parameters of the fuel injection are controlled, and due to the precise fuel injection, the combustion is improved, and due to the improved combustion, the performance of the engine is improved, the fuel economy is improved, the emissions are also reduced, and even the availability of the torque at low speed is also there. The torque is available, high torque, maximum torque can be made available even at low speeds, thus by improving the performance of the engine, by improving the combustion, which is improved by the proper fuel injection, by using the advanced system like CRDI system, common rail direct injection system. And the pressure inside this common rail or the header pipe, this is the common rail or the header pipe, the pressure is 1600 bar. So the advantages of CRDI, advantages of common rail direct injection system, is that first is precise fuel metering and control. So precisely the fuel is metered, and the spray of the fuel or the injection of the fuel is controlled precisely by the CRDI system. We are using only one pump for increasing the pressure of the fuel. Even if the engine is having more than one cylinder, so we have seen the four cylinder engine for which the four injectors were there, but the fuel pump is a single. Additionally, we may require the lift pump for lifting the fuel from the fuel tank to the main fuel pump. Then the variable load and speed requirements are fulfilled. Even if there is a sudden change in speed, sudden change in load, so all these requirements are fulfilled, and the vehicle is having good pickup due to this system. Fixed pressure is maintained in the common header or the common rail, so that we can open any injector at any time, and pressurized fuel will be available to be injected inside the engine cylinder. So fixed pressure is maintained throughout the fuel injection cycle. Throughout the fuel injection cycle, fixed pressure of the fuel is maintained. The maintenance is low. Maintenance is low means, since the component performance, the components are actually costly, so the components will hardly fail, but the cost of the components is high. So the maintenance frequency is less, but whenever there is maintenance, the maintenance cost, especially for replacement of the parts, will be more. So the same point can be called as the disadvantage, that though the maintenance is low, but the maintenance cost is high if we have to replace some component of this particular fuel injection system, CRDI system. The system itself is also costly. It is a sophisticated, complicated system, and therefore its initial cost is also high. That will increase the cost of the vehicle, and this system requires accurate design. That is also one of the disadvantages of the CRDI system. So this was about the advantages and disadvantages of CRDI, and about the CRDI, that is the common rail direct injection system. Now let us study the diagnostic tools for fault finding of two-wheeler. Which tools we are using for finding out the faults in the two-wheelers? So nowadays, in this advanced technology time, most of the problems are electronic, because the system consists of so many electronic components, so many controls are there. These controls are electronic. So these fault finding equipment is also electronic based. So let us study these tools one by one. First is the scan tool, then the AccuSmart charger, Power Pro 3, multimeters are also used, new gas analyzer is being used, and the battery tester is also used. So you can see that most of these tools are electrical or electronic based. The first tool is the scan tool. So it is an electronic tool, and with the help of this tool we can interface with, or we can diagnose, or even sometimes we can reprogram the vehicle control modules. So the vehicle control modules can be diagnosed, they can be interfaced with, or sometimes if required they can be reprogrammed also with the help of the scan tool. So we are adopting the common fault finding procedures, especially for the injectors. For the fuel injectors, the common fault finding procedures are used, and here the ignition coil, fuel pump, etc. are written in the tool. So what are the common fault finding procedures for the injectors, for the ignition coils, fuel pump, etc. are written in the tool. Now the factory service procedures, like resetting the service light and encoding keys, unlocking the immobilizer and configuring the immobilizer alarm is also done. Adjusting the throttle valve position sensors. So the throttle valve position is sensed by the electronic control unit. First of all, it is sensed by the sensors, and the output is given to the electronic control unit. So this position, these sensors can be adjusted. The throttle valve position sensors can also be adjusted if they are slightly not proper, and making injection adjustment. Fuel injection can also be adjusted. The duration of the fuel injection, the timing of the fuel injection, the fuel injection rate. So these parameters can be adjusted if they are found to be slightly incorrect. And the auto adaptive can also be reset with the help of the scan tool. So all these are nothing but the electronic settings. So these electronic settings are done with the help of the scan tool. So this scan tool will first of all give the information whether these settings are disturbed or not. So if it is observed by the scan tool that the settings are disturbed, so these settings can be adjusted according to the use, according to the requirement. The settings can be adjusted, all these electronic settings can be adjusted with the help of the scan tool. Now the scan tool will also show the live data. It will display the ECU data. The electronic control unit data will also be displayed by the scan tool. So what data is received by the electronic control unit? And the electronic scan tool will also read the stored faults, or live data like RPM can also be read by the scan tool. The battery voltage can be read, noted by the scan tool. And the throttle angle, position of the throttle valve, the angular position of the throttle valve can also be considered by the scan tool. Now the functions of the scan tool are to view the ECU data. The data which is present in the electronic control unit can be viewed with the help of the scan tool. then it can read and erase the stored fault code. If some wrong codes, if some faulty codes are present, so that can be read, that can be detected, and they can be erased, so that the programming of the vehicle will be proper, and the running of the vehicle, the controlling of the vehicle, that is the fuel injection, then the spark production timings, then the flow rate of the air, of the charge, the openings of the injectors. So all these things can be made appropriate with the help of the scan tool. The display live data can be displayed with the help of the scan tool, and the diagnostic tests can be run to make certain adjustments. So certain adjustments can be made by running the diagnostic tests with the help of the scan tool. The next device is the AccuSmart charger. So this AccuSmart charger is used in diagnosis for short circuit, voltage peak of AC to DC, polarity inversion, overheating and voltage spikes. So all the electricity related faults, electric faults, can be detected by the AccuSmart charger. If there is some short circuit, so what is the position of the short circuit, what is the voltage peak of AC to DC, what is the polarity inversion, if there is some overheating or if there are some voltage spikes, so they can be read by the AccuSmart charger, can be detected by the AccuSmart charger. The charger analyzes the battery automatically and checks its voltage. So this AccuSmart charger will automatically analyze the battery, and the voltage of the battery can also be checked by the AccuSmart charger. So a pulse charge will start for the recondition of slightly sulfated batteries. So in the due course of time, by using the battery may get slightly sulfated. So by using a pulse charge, the batteries can be reconditioned. The AccuSmart charger will start a pulse charge, and with the help of this pulse charge, the reconditioning of the batteries can also be done. Now during the step of recharge, the voltage supplied to the battery increases. When the charger is charging the batteries, the voltage supplied to the battery will be increased, and the charger delivers a medium to high charging current. Medium to high charging current will be delivered by the charger, will be delivered by the AccuSmart charger, and this will increase the 80% recharge of the battery, or the battery will be recharged up to 80% with the help of this AccuSmart charger. And due to the absorption step, the charger supplies a constant voltage up to the complete recharge of the battery. So the voltage which is supplied by the AccuSmart charger up to the complete recharge of the battery will be constant. A constant voltage will be supplied by this AccuSmart charger till the battery is completely, or in this case 80% recharge. Next is the Power Probe 3. Next tool for finding faults in the two-wheelers, diagnostic tool, is nothing but the Power Probe 3. So Power Probe 3 is used in the diagnosis of speed for regular maintenance. So the diagnosis of speed is done by the Power Probe 3, and this is the part of the regular scheduled maintenance. And the troubleshooting of problems on electrical systems. So if there are any problems on the electrical systems, these problems will be detected, and the troubleshooting of these problems can be done with the help of the Power Probe 3. We are also using the multimeters for finding faults, for the diagnosis of the faults in the two-wheelers. So these multimeters are necessary to find the location of the fault. With the help of the multimeters, the exact location of the fault can be found out. That means there is an electric circuit and at which point of the circuit the fault is present can be found out with the help of the multimeter by testing with the various points. Various electrical points can be tested by the multimeters, and then the fault can be located. Now for general purpose, we are using the digital multimeters. The advantage of digital multimeters is that they are easy to read, but the digital multimeters are not so accurate, but easily they can be read, and therefore they are suitable for the general purpose. AC as well as DC measurements are also possible with the help of these multimeters, and these multimeters has a full set of leads and probes which are used for the measurement of the current and voltage, AC as well as DC. Now the important device is the flue gas analyzer. The fault finding device is the flue gas analyzer. So it is used to measure the concentrations of various gases, various flue gases in the exhaust. Various harmful gases are present, like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxides. So these are the harmful pollutants present in the exhaust of the engine. So these gases are CO means carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxide, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide. Particulate matter may also be present in the exhaust gases. So these are the exhaust gases contents, and the emission of these harmful pollutants can be reduced by efficient combustion. So in order to reduce the emission of these harmful pollutants, first of all we should know that what is the quantity, what is the percentage of these harmful components and harmful gases emitted, and then we can go for the measures for reducing this harmful pollutants, reducing the percentage, the quantity of the harmful pollutants. So if you reduce the quantity of the harmful pollutants, then the combustion will be efficient, and efficient combustion will lead to the better performance of the engine. That means the power output will be increased, the efficiency or the fuel economy will be increased, and the emissions will also be reduced. So the torque availability at lower speeds will also be increased if the combustion is efficient. Now last device is nothing but the battery tester. We are also using the battery tester as a diagnostic tool for fault finding of two-wheelers. So this electronic device tests the state of an electric battery. So what is the state, what is the condition of the electric battery? So how much the battery is used? So when we go on using the electric battery, we will find that the capacity of the battery to store the charge and provide the required output voltage decreases day by day. So we have to replace the battery. So it is necessary to test the battery, test the condition of the battery. So this battery tester is an electronic device which will test the condition of the electric battery, and there are some simple testers also to test the output voltage by testing the charge actually present in the cells. So the output voltage can be tested by testing the charge which is actually present in the cells by simple testers. So we can use the simple testers, or we can also use the comprehensive testers, so that the exact condition of the battery can be tested, and the capacity of the battery to accumulate charge and the possible flaws can be detected by the comprehensive testers. And these possible flaws which affect the performance and security of the battery can be detected by the comprehensive testers, by the advanced testers, so that the detailed information regarding the battery conditions can be obtained, and appropriate decision regarding the changing or the recharge of the battery can be taken. So this was all about the diagnostic tools which are used for the fault finding of two-wheeler. Thank you, my dear friends.